Brethren from PCM Akadara Parish, we want to greet you this morning in the name of Jesus. Praise God.
Amen.
We are grateful once again to bring to you the Word of God, which is going to guide us throughout this week, as we normally call it the online service. Our parish minister is going to share with us. And I believe that we are going to be blessed by God, and we shall also receive a word that is going to keep us going as we continue in this journey of life. Our sermon this morning is going to come from the book of Joshua chapter number 7, verses 1 to 14. Joshua chapter number 7, from verse 1 to 14. And I believe that God is going to bless us. Let us read together for those of us who are ready. The Bible says, "The Lord's command to Israel not to take from Jericho anything that was to be destroyed was not obeyed. A man named Achan disobeyed that order, and so the Lord was furious with the Israelites. Achan was the son of Carmi and grandson of Zabdi, had belonged to the clan of Zerah, a part of the tribe of Judah. Joshua sent some men from Jericho to Ai, a city east of Bethel, near Bethaven, with the orders to go and explore the land. When they had done so, they reported back to Joshua, 'There is no need for everyone to attack Ai. Send only about 2,000 or 3,000 men. Don't send the whole army up there to fight it. It is not a large city.' So about 3,000 Israelites made the attack, but they were forced to retreat. The man of Ai chased them from the city gate as far as some quarries and killed about 36 of them in the way down the hill. Then the Israelites lost their courage and were afraid. Joshua and leaders of Israel tore their clothes in grief, threw themselves to the ground before the Lord's covenant box, and lay there till evening with dust on their heads to show their sorrow. And Joshua said, 'Sovereign Lord, why did you bring us across the Jordan at all to hand us over to the Amorites to destroy us? Why didn't you just stay in the other side of the Jordan? What can I say, O Lord, now that Israel has retreated from the enemy? The Canaanites and everyone else in the country will hear about it. They will surround us and kill every one of us. And then, what will you do to protect your honor?' The Lord said to Joshua, 'Get up. Why are you lying on the ground like this? Israel has sinned. They have broken the agreement with the Lord, with me, that I ordered them to keep. They have taken some of the things condemned to destruction. They stole them, lied about it, and put them with their own things. This is why the Israelites cannot stand against their enemies. They retreat from them because they themselves have not been condemned to destruction. I will not stay with you any longer unless you destroy the things you are ordered not to take.' Verse 13, 'Get up, purify the people and get them ready to come before me. Tell them to be ready tomorrow, because I, the Lord, God of Israel, have this to say: Israel, you have in your possession some things that I ordered you to destroy. You cannot stand against your enemies until you get rid of these things. Verse 14. So tell them that in the morning they will be brought forward tribe by tribe. The tribe that I will pick out will then come forward, clan by clan. The clan that I will pick out will come forward, family by family. The family that I will pick out will come forward one by one. That is the word of God.
Let's pray. Let's pray. Almighty and everlasting God, we are before you this morning, ready to listen to your call, because it is you who has called us, Lord. Now talk to us all in a manner that each one of us, wherever he is or she is, will understand and hearken to your voice. Be with us, Lord, for the short time that you will be here, and bless us, for it is in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Thank you, Christopher, for the scripture that you have read to us. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, the scripture that has been read to us in Joshua chapter 7, from verse 1 to 14, we cannot understand it unless we go back to Joshua chapter 6. And I want to draw a theme from that scripture that he says, obeying God's order. Obeying God's order. Brothers and sisters, Christianity is all about, number one, repentance. Christianity is all about obedience. Christianity is all about faithfulness. And finally, Christianity is all about righteousness. Hayo mambo manne ni muhimu sana kwetu sisi wa Kristo. Now, in chapter 6, when you look at chapter 6, it talks about the fall of Jericho. And Jericho, as we all know, is one of the oldest towns which are mentioned in the Bible. One of the oldest towns. And Jericho, the way it was built, it was well built, such that nobody could go in or go out without the permission of the guards who are guarding the town of Jericho. It was well built. It was a fortified city. But then, though Jericho was fortified, Joshua captured the town of Jericho very easily because he went or he listened to the advice that God had given him. And when you look at Moses, who led the Israelites from Egypt, we see that when Moses was in the wilderness, he gathered the Israelites together and reminded them of what God expected them to do in the wilderness. And when Moses died and Joshua took over, Joshua assembled the Israelites at a place called Shechem, and he reminded them of what God expected them to do. Brothers and sisters, we see that Joshua followed all the instructions that God had given him on how to attack Jericho. And that's the reason why he won this battle very easily. But then God instructed Joshua that after they captured the town of Jericho, there were some conditions that they were given. And the conditions were that do not take any plunder. Anything, do not take any plunder. Everything was to be destroyed completely, except the lady who was called Rahab. Except Rahab. That's number one. Number two, anything that was made of gold, anything that was made of silver, bronze and iron, that one was considered to be sacred. Therefore, they were to be brought to the Lord's treasury. Ziletwe na siwekwe kule. But everything else was to be destroyed. But in chapter 6, after Joshua and his men defeated Jericho and they captured it, we see that there are some people, or not people, really a person who took some things that were supposed to be destroyed and he carried them. The reason is because of greed. Greed, gukoroka, greed. Akabeba, akaenda nazo, kwa sababu aliangalia akaona ni nzuri. My dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, I want to say that there are things that belong to our God. There are things that belong to our God, and I'm not talking about gold, silver, bronze, and iron. There are things that belong to God, and we must surrender them to Him, because they belong to Him. Number one, it is important to note that actually our hearts, we must surrender our hearts to our Lord. And it is 100%. Tunajipeana kabisa, ngweneana pio. Number two, it is praise. Praise belongs to our God. Number three, it is honor. Honor negeti o mwangi. Honor. Honor belongs to God. And finally, all the tithes belong to our God. Madani Agosho. So when you look at the, when you come to verse 18 of chapter 6, actually the Israelites are told very clearly what would happen if they don't obey the command of God. They are told that if you don't obey what I have said, you will be completely destroyed. Condition number, they will be completely destroyed. Number two, God tells them that you will bring trouble to Israel. Kama kunaye atachukua kitu ambacho ni cha kuharibiwa. Kama kunaye atachukua kitu ambacho ni cha ambacho kinataikana kupeana kwa Mungu. Number one, they will be completely destroyed. Number two, they will bring trouble to Israel. But then they were to save Rahab. And you all know Rahab, who was Rahab. You know, he still tells us that she was a professional prostitute. Why is God saying that Rahab should be spared? Because Rahab saved the Israelites. Yes, and our court. But as was few. So when you come to chapter 7 now, we find that now, after Joshua had defeated a very strong town of Jericho, the next town that was to be attacked was a town called Ai, a very small town. So what Joshua did is that he sent some spies to go and spy and see how strong is this town of Ai. So the report that came was that, that's a very small town. It is just a walkover. What are we seeing here? When Joshua was attacking Jericho, he consulted God. And God gave his strategy. But when Joshua is attacking Ai, he sent some spies and he relied on the information that was brought. Because they said, we don't need to take too many people there, so we can take that 1,000 soldiers. He relied on the report that it was given. Brothers and sisters, when they attacked Ai, the Bible is very clear that these people were defeated, they were chased away, and that the six were killed. That the six were killed. Why are these people being defeated? Why are they being killed? It's because one of them, and it is written in plural, that they had disobeyed. But is it true that all the Israelites had disobeyed? No, it is only one person called Akan. Kwa hivyo walichapwa, wakatoroka. So what we see is that Joshua now, because of that, Joshua started questioning God. God, why have you given us to our enemies to be defeated and to be killed? Why? So Joshua is quarreling. He is quarreling God. But the question is, was it the problem of God or the problem of the Israelites? God had no mistake. He had not done any mistake. Because he had told them, when you attack Jericho, don't take any plunder. But they carried the plunder. brothers and sisters, this is one person who has committed a sin. And now, the whole community of Israel is suffering. Let us look at the result of Achan's sin. Kwa sababu ni dhambi ya mtu mmoja tu, ndio inafanya hawa watu waumie. Number one, if you read from chapter 7 verse 5, we see that many people died. Many people lost their life, Israelites, because of the sin of only one person. Inasema nini, Kisova? Chapter 7 verse 5.
The Bible says, the men of Ai chased them from...
They chased the men of Ai, chased the Israelites, and they murdered them like grasshoppers. Waliwaua kuwaua. So, one of the result that occurred after Achan committed a sin of taking plunder, which was not supposed to, is that many Israelites lost their lives. Just because of the sin of only one person. Number two is that Israel's army melted in fear. Waisraeli walikuwa wanajulikana ni watu ambao ni washujaa. Adomare mamari no rumemuno. But because of the sin of Achan, these people melted in fear. Walianza kuogopa na hawangeendelea mbele just because of the sin of one person. If you read Joshua chapter 7, verse 7 to 9, we see number 3 is that Joshua questioned God and he started doubting God. Alianza kuuliza Mungu maswali na akaanza kuona hai na huyu si yule Mungu ambaye tulikuwa tunatarajia. Haya, sio hivyo. Joshua questioned God and he started doubting God. Why? Because of the sin of Achan. Number 4, we see this is very serious. We see God threatening to withdraw his presence from the Israelites. God threatened. He said, I will not be with you. God threatened to withdraw or to abandon them completely. But finally, number 5, it is very serious. From Joshua chapter 7, verse 24 to 26, we see Achan himself, who committed the sin, Achan himself, his family, and even the property were all destroyed. The question is, why is the family being destroyed? Because of the sin of only one person. Brothers and sisters, it is very important to mind about what other people are doing who are within your ministry. Achan was an individual who committed sin, but Israel suffered. I said, Christianity is all about repentance. Christianity is all about forgiveness. Christianity is all about faithfulness. Christianity is all about righteousness. When Israel were told the mistake or the sin that they had committed, we see Joshua and all the leaders tearing their clothes, pouring ash on their heads in sorrow. What are we saying? They accepted the sin that they had committed. When they were told their mistakes, they accepted the sin that they had committed. Therefore, brothers and sisters, what are we saying? We are saying Joshua and all the leader and the Israelites repented. Then, Joshua, the leaders, and the people of Israel repented. After they repented, what were the results? Hey! What were the results? Number one, if you read Joshua chapter 8, verse 1, we see God encouraging the Israelites. What is he saying? Chapter 8, verse 1.
Verse 1 says, Joshua 8, 1. The Lord said to Joshua.
This is God who is talking to Joshua now. He said to Joshua,
Take all soldiers with you.
After they had repented, Joshua is being told to God, take all the soldiers with you. And do what?
And go.
Go and attack Ai now. When I saw Sifiwe. After Joshua and the people of Israel repented, now God is encouraging them now. You know, God had threatened to withdraw his presence. But because of the repentance, God is assuring them that he will be with them. God encouraged them. God promised his presence in the matter. And what God did in one mother, with God's presence in this war that we are fighting, we are assured of victory. Number two, God promised them that He Himself would guide them, and He promised the victory. God promised them that He Himself, as their God, He would guide them, He would lead them, and He assured them of victory. The key one is, it is after repentance. What else is fewer? No, Rura Muega, no, Niatiri. God and forbidden them to take any plunder, anything. But after they repented and assured God that they were to follow Him faithfully, if you read chapter all of chapter 8, what we see is that God is allowing them now that they can keep the plunder. Wakipiga muji, sasa wanaweza chukua vitu na wajiwekee wao wenyewe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Brothers and sisters, because of this repentance now of Joshua and the whole people of Israel owning their sin, God, throughout Israel's history, God promised blessings. And that's the reason why even today, Israel is blessed. Brothers and sisters, the message is very simple. The message is very simple. At times when the task seems very easy, when a task seems very easy, it's not heavy, we try to go with our own wisdom, with our own strength. But the point is, any time that you decide to undertake a task, number one, just consult God. Because the failure of Joshua was that he decided to attack Ai, because he was told that Ai is just a small, a weak town, using his own knowledge, intelligence, and his strength. Brothers and sisters, always just consult God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
Unajua sasa huu mwaka wa 2021 uko na mambo mengi kisofu. Huu mwaka uko na mambo mengi. Huyu uko na mambo mengi. Na watu wanajiendesha tu, wanajiongoza tu. I want to say this. The reason why Israel suffered, number one, it is because they are distorted. That one we emphasize so much, that walichukua mali ambayo Mungu alikuwa amekataza. But if you read verse 11, kuna kitu kiko pale. They were destroyed because they lied. Walidanganya. They lied. Wapendwa katika Bwana, Wakristo wengi wamezoea kudanganya. Na wanaona kama udanganyifu sio kitu ambacho kinaudhi Mwenyezi Mungu. Brothers and sisters, let us learn to talk the truth. However, bila juhudi. Unajua alidanganya? Walisema yeye sisi tumepiga muji na hakuna kitu tumechukua. It is important to learn to talk the truth. It doesn't matter how bitter the truth is, but always talk the truth. 2021, it is a matter of obedience. We must obey what God says. Because if we don't obey Christopher, God is promising to withdraw His presence. And when God withdraws, you know we cannot go very far. Therefore, brothers of Bakandara and the rest of the world who are watching us, the lesson today is that we obey God's orders. Because there are those orders that God has given us. So it is we obey or we obey. Because if we disobey, God is saying that He is not ready to walk with us the year 2021. And the good thing is that when we obey, He promises to lead us. He promises victory. He promises even all the things that He had forbidden us from taking, He is allowing us to own them. Therefore, let us be people of obedience as we continue fighting, because we are in a war. As we continue fighting in this war, we obey God's commands. And all will be well with us. God bless you, and God do you good. Baba, katika jina la Yesu Kristo, umetuambia kwamba Wewe ni Mungu mtakatifu na ukisema umesema. Kwa hivyo ombi letu ni Mwenyezi Mungu ni ya kwamba utusaidie tu kufuata maagizo yako ndio uweze kutembea pamoja nasi. Kama vile tumeanza huu mwaka uko na mambo mengi. Politically iko mambo mengi mengi ambayo yanaongewa. Lakini Mwenyezi Mungu umetufundisha kwamba lazima tuongee ukweli. Kwa sababu tukiongea ukweli wewe utakuwa pamoja nasi. So walk with us throughout this journey because without you Lord, we cannot go very far. Be with us Father, do us good because we are your children. It's a prayer of faith in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Amen.